Bunny.
Are you guys ready for the May favorites? Maybe. Maybe are you ready for May?
Lame joke. I actually don't think I have that many favorite things this month. Should I just jump right in? Is that okay? I feel like I'm without banter tonight. If you follow me on Instagram, you probably saw all the sushi that I was eating tonight, so I'm absolutely in a sushi coma. So I'm just like, But today is like the last day in May, so I can't really put it off till June. Now, can I? I guess my first favorite of the month is Rangs. Didn't I say this in April? Did I say it? Did I predict this? I'm crazy now about bracelets. Plus, most of these bracelets and rings were sent to me in Swamp Family Mail. So this is all from you guys. So it's like a celebration of the love that I feel from you guys sending me mail in my Swamp Family P.O. box. And also, I'm crazy about rings. I bought this one with Leanne Says. We went shopping in Galvey to a bunch of, like, Galveston. If you've ever been to Galveston, probably most islands or tourist places have a bunch of tourist trappy kind of junk jewelry. That is my favorite jewelry. A lot of people say that it looks like a rose, but I don't really think it is. It just has this filigree stuff on the side and then this gigantic black honking stone, and it cost me like $7. So that was pretty cool. I'm on the hunt for rings, or at least I was all May, but I really think that that trend will stick with me through, what is next month? January, February, March, April, May, June. June! Oh my god, when all the bugs come out. How can I forget this? Next thing I'm gonna tell you guys about, I don't know if I've ever talked about this on my channel, but it is an absolute lifesaver. It's kind of an investment, though with most beauty technology type things, I have seen the price greatly drop over the past 4 or 5 months. I bought this little device back in November, I believe, because I got some kind of discount. I bought it at a department store. I got it from Dillard's. So I got some kind of discount. I don't know why. It was some Christmas party. Anyway, that doesn't matter, right? If you guys have acne-prone skin, or you have breakouts, and I know I always say this wrong, rosacea, rosacea. I always say rosacea, and then people are like, where's the S sound, bunny? Rosacea. If you have that, this really does improve those problems. If you've been on my channel for a while, you probably saw I went out to Florida, Walt Disney World, for 2 weeks, and I forgot this little thing at home. Remembered to bring the charger, forgot to bring the device. That is kind of why I think I'm having these little bumpy, I guess it's called like cystic acne. I'm suddenly like Russian or something. I don't even know where I was going with that. But I have these little like bumpy things on my forehead. They're not really pimples or anything. TMI, this is totally a gross moment right now. But that usually comes up like if I'm not properly scrubbing my face. So anyway, long story short, they came out with a new deep pore cleansing scrub brush pad. Every skin type, is that right? Skin type. Every type of skin you have, they have a particular brush for your needs. So acne, deep pore, if you've got a lot of problem areas like I do right now, oily skin, dry skin, sensitive skin, delicate skin, all kinds of skin. For a singular brush, I think it's like $22, and then for a pack of two brushes, I want to say it's like $40. I don't know. That math somehow makes logic happen when you buy it. You somehow save money by buying the double pack instead of the singular. This is worth the investment. I believe that Clarisonic Mia's are now like $124 or something. That was the most long-winded blah 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 of the video, I promise. Next favorite I got sent to me in a beauty box that I sampled this month called Beauty Box 5 out of Austin, Texas, and they sent me a can of Psst dry shampoo. This actually is now my new favorite dry shampoo, and trust me, I've tried nearly every single one on the market. My other favorite one was, I believe, in the TG line, Rockstar, something like that, but it's a ridiculous like $20 a can for some powder in a can. That's just unacceptable. And a lot of you guys actually told me that I could get this at Walgreens for $3, and sure enough, you can get this at Walgreens for like $3. So that's way cheaper than any of the TG stuff or other salon brands. So just get some Psst instead and Psst your hair away. That'll be great. It has a nice smell, which isn't really that smelly. and it's more better. Anyway, next, I actually made a list. Next thing on my list is a new type of purple shampoo that I have tried out this month. And I know purple shampoo isn't the thing for everyone, but if you have lavender or light blonde or you get highlights, yada yada, then this is probably the best brand that I can recommend to you guys. Once again, I've tried a complete array. I've tried the Shimmer Lights, which is just the normal kind of like drugstore type brand. This is even cheaper than Shimmer Lights. This was only $3.59 at Sally Beauty Supply. I've also tried some of the higher end ones like Joico and blah 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 blah, like stuff that you get at Ulta that you pay $30 a bottle for. And I'm just gonna say that this is way more effective than any of the pricier ones. This conditioner actually works great as well. My hair has been so disgustingly dry lately. That's why I haven't been getting it touched up. I know it looks disgusting. I know you can maybe see my roots sometimes when I have my hair down, but we're all just gonna have to deal with it because I'm really trying to get my hair, I've said 100,000 times, kind of like Sweeney Todd-like. Like, I want it white and black, and I keep trying to lighten up the blonde. I really need to find somebody in Houston that does killer hair. So if you're in Houston and you're a beautician, drop me a line on my Facebook page. This is no joke, because the guy who's usually been doing my hair, like, he literally fried the hell out of my hair last time. It's just been so dry since the last time I got it dyed, which was sometime in April, I believe. And I swear, I keep going in there. I'm like, I want the white. And it always comes out kind of blonde still. And it's like I'm speaking an alien language and people can't understand what the hell I want. I'm like, white, black. I know it can be done. So many people have artificial white hair. Why not me? Anyway, this is a great shampoo if you need purple shampoo. Next thing is actually a huge discovery for me this month. If you've been on my channel for a couple months, you know I've been having horrible foundation problems, right? We've been through this, just the ups and downs of different MAC shades and different MAC foundations and Yves Saint Laurent, which just was a nasty experience after a while. More on that later. By the way, I'm not calling anyone a moron. I just like to say it. Moron. That later. Haha. Haha. If you've been on my channel literally since the dawn of caveman times, then you know that I've been a long-term fan of Lumines airbrushing stuff. I had the old system, but I contacted them and asked them if they'd let me try out the new system because they have reformulated the systems. They've reformulated the makeups. It's an entirely new, different thing, and they actually said yes, which is crazy. It's much, much smaller this time. I don't know if you guys are familiar with the older systems, which were really kind of bigger, not so travel friendly. So this is the smaller system. And I actually did a complete entire video all about this, but I just didn't want people to like freak out about it and be like, oh, you review things too much. So I'm gonna make an entirely different video focused completely on Lumines, but it is my new staple. I got the system about 2 weeks ago, and I am so blown away with the new formula of the makeup. No joke. Once again, just like the Clarisonic thing, it's not really a cheap thing to get into, but I would argue that it's worth the investment and that you're gonna get a better quality. That's just my personal opinion, my personal, honest opinion. I was a big fan of airbrushing when it first came out, and then for some reason, I kind of forgot about it, and then I saw the buzz about the new Lumines systems. I've tried it out. So for anybody who's been wondering what foundation I've been using over the past, you know, basic almost month, because we're going on week 3 that I've had it now, that is the only foundation I've been using, and it is the only foundation that I'm going to continue to use. I really don't think that I'm ever gonna switch back to any other kind of brand. I'm pretty much completely sold on Lumines now, because I've been so impressed with the results, with the look, with the effortlessness. I could literally go on for the span of a whole video. So that's why I'm gonna make a whole video on that. Stay tuned for that. That'll probably be in June, because today's the last day of May. Next thing I want to tell you guys about, which is on my lips right now, it's another thing I've been getting a lot of questions about throughout this entire month, and I mentioned it in my Dark Shadows giveaway video, and that is the Tarte Lip Chubby Lipstick Balm Tint. What do they call this thing? Lip Surgence Natural Matte Lip Tint. There you go. So that's what it is. That's a mouthful, right? I got it in one of my Sephora point perk things a couple months ago. I had never used it. I just got it because it was kind of a brand that I've heard a little bit of buzz about, but I never really was like, oh, Tarte, you know? I don't know why. I just never, maybe because I was kind of grossed out about that whole like cheek and lip thing. I really am not a fan of like combo products. Like I'm like, either tell me to put it on my cheeks or on my mouth, not on both. We have another mosquito in here. This is really disgusting. God. Anyway, so I picked this up on a whim. I almost just stabbed my eye out with it, Oedipus Rex style. Picked this up on a whim. It was just sitting on my bathroom counter, and I kind of didn't really feel like putting on lipstick that day, but I really didn't feel like just going with a pencil, and so I thought I would layer this over a pencil just to kind of see how it is. I am amazingly, amazingly impressed with this thing. I went out today kind of sampling some of the other, like, chubby lip pencil things on the market. I kind of swatched the Clinique ones. I really don't think that the Clinique ones are as good as the Tarte ones. These are incredibly pigmented. As I'm sure you guys can tell, the Clinique ones are more glossy. So if you like more of a gloss type texture, go with the Clinique ones. I saw Leanne says, I mention her all the time. She's my friend. She just did a review on the ones by Revlon, I believe, and I've not yet gotten to try one of those. So maybe I can do an entire video on that if that would be something you guys would be interested in. Like, would the red one from the Revlon collection be a dupe for the Tarte one? I'm kind of shocked with how expensive this is. It is $24, I believe. It's either $22 or $24. So I know that's kind of an expensive product. So I don't know. Maybe if you're interested in this kind of thing, try the Revlon one first. The other thing that I'm crazy about is some nail polish. I've mentioned this brand before. I found this specific shade the other day when I was at the spa. I'm not exactly sure where else you can buy this brand. I always joke about the name. It's called Spa Ritual, but I always like to say it's Spa Ritual, like I had a Spa Ritual experience. Old joke, not funny anymore. I'm pretty sure that it is vegan. Yeah, it says right here, vegan. This color, I immediately fell in love with it. I kind of saw it in the shadows at the spa ritual. And it was part of some kind of ocean, seaside, underwater kind of collection. If you've ever been on my Tumblr page, you know I'm obsessed with everything underwater. This shade is called Lucid. It is kind of a periwinkle, bluish, purplish, kind of light, magical, semi-pastel color. I'm just gonna keep saying everything that comes into my head. This is what it looks like. I have it painted on my phalanges right now. I think it's beautiful. I also have it on my toes. The other polish that I'm crazy about is from the OPI, something about ballet dancers. Ballet dancers are still a thing. I thought that kind of went out with Black Swan, or I almost said Black Dolphin. Can they make another, like a sequel? Black Dolphin. Would that be cool? I think so. I would watch it. I never watched Black Swan, actually, so I'm just being full of crap right now. But it's from something having with witch to do with fancy New York and ballet dancers, right? So I love chunky glitter top coats. Love chunky glitter top coats, literally. If it's got a chunky piece of glitter in it, I probably own it. It's called Pirouette My Whistle. That is disgusting. We need to immediately give this a new name on the swamp. Who allowed that at OPI? No. This is about $8.50, I think, but it's a really lovely glittery top coat despite its slightly suggestively disturbing name. We'll just overlook that. I have that as a top coat on my accent phalange. I really do not think at all that this is a standalone polish. I've had a couple glitter polishes that are standalone polishes. This is really just a top coat though, so don't try and just put it on alone. You won't like it. I promise you won't. Next polish actually came to me all the way from the swamp in the UK from a subscriber named Becky. So thank you so much for this. But I have to mention this polish. I've worn it 3 or 4 times this month already. I've gotten a lot of compliments from you guys in videos when you've seen it or you've asked me what it is. Now, I will say this. I was kind of like scoping around to see if this shade or this type of Rimmel polish is available in the US. And I must say that so far I've not found found it. It's the Rimmel 60 Seconds, and this is in shade Sky High. Since I didn't buy this, I have no idea how much it cost or, like I said, where you can get it. It just happily landed in my lap, so thank you so much for that. Anyways, I will see you guys tomorrow, which is next month. Like I mentioned a couple of videos ago, please do head over to my Instagram because I'm putting the finishing touches on the Instagram June Photo A Day Challenge tonight, right now. Past, present, and future. I am utterly obsessed with Instagram. It's like my new favorite thing. It's been my favorite for like 2 months now. At first I thought it was like completely stupid, and then somehow I got like looped into it, and now it's like a black hole. And I found Instagram fan pages. I found an entire Instagram fan page dedicated to Johnny Depp. So it's like just randomly throughout my day, it's like, oh, there's a picture of Johnny Depp, which, you know, I'm 12, so I like things like that. How many people are gonna take me seriously that I just said I'm 12? Just, do I look 12? Do I look 12? Do I? Fountain of youth. I love you guys. Thank you so much for the mail that you've sent me this week. It's truly brightened my day. I think maybe I'm catching a cold, so I'm gonna go read some mail from you guys right now to make myself feel better before I start freaking out. I need to make a new video about dealing with anxiety, don't I? Don't I? I do. Thank you so much for being here. As I always say, please take a minute to subscribe, leave me a comment down below, let me know how you feel about any of these products, if you've used any of these products. Let me know on Facebook. You can like me on Facebook. And if you do like me, let me know if you're a hairstylist in Houston. I'm so dead serious. Serious. Let me know. I need help. And I need a touch up. You can follow me if you want on Twitter, Tumblr, or Instagram. Please do. And I love you guys. I will see you guys later. Take care. Have fun. Beware of June bugs. They come out in June, especially if you live on the swamp. They will literally pick you up and carry you away to some distant, scary bug island where... Bug juice! Did any of y'all drink bug juice? It's a 90s moment! Okay, I'm done. Bye!